This draw preview is brought to you by our partners at BetUS. BetUS have over 25 years experience in the sports betting market and are not only America's favorite sports book, but they offer their services to people all around the world. And they want to offer you a 125% sign-up bonus on your first deposit using the link down below. Also, by signing up with BetUS using the link down below, you are supporting what we do on the channel. If you love the live shows, if you love these draw previews, click the link down below to show your support for the channel. Appreciate your support, everybody, and let's get back to the video. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another draw preview, and we have one of the biggest draw previews of the year outside of the majors, the ATP Cup, one of the biggest events on the ATP calendar, and we have a stacked field of players in this one. Let's go straight to the rankings. All right, let's go to the groups for the ATP Cup. We have Group A. It has Serbia, the number one seed. We have Germany, the number six seed, and Canada, the number 11 seed in Group A. In Group B, we have number two seed Spain. They'll be playing against Greece, who are the number five seed, and Australia, who are the number 12 seed, thanks to a wild card because they are the host nation. In Group C, probably the most open group in my opinion, we have Austria, the number three seed. They'll be playing against Italy, who are the number eight seed, and France, who are the number 10 seed. And like I said, that group is very open. A lot of good players in that one. And in Group D, we have Russia as the number four seed. They'll be playing against Argentina, the number seven seed, and Japan, the number nine seed. So starting with Group A, we have Novak Djokovic's Serbia versus Denis Shapovalov's Canada. So we get the number one players playing each other with Djokovic versus Shapovalov. Djokovic has a 5-0 head-to-head record, 4-0 on hard courts. But the last time they played, it was a close three-set match with a tiebreaker in the third. Actually, it was this time last year at this event. Then the second matchup is going to be Ljubic versus Raonic. The number two is playing each other. 1-1 in their head-to-head, but it's 1-0 in favor of Raonic on a hard court. And Ljubic is on a six-match losing streak on hard court. The last time he won a hard court match was 12 months ago in Acapulco last year. So that is a very big stat. Ljubic doesn't really like playing on hard courts at the moment. All right, let's move over to Group B, where we have the host nation, Australia, who got a wild card into this tournament. They're playing against Rafa Nadal and Batista Agu and Spain, who will probably have the strongest team all around when we look at their doubles as well. Nadal versus Dimonor will be the number ones playing against each other. It's actually 3-0 in favor of Rafa in their head-to-head, 2-0 on a hard court. But the last match they played, which was the ATP Cup last year, it was a three-set match, and Dimonor had chances to win that. So that will be a very intriguing matchup 12 months on. Then we have Batista Agu versus Milman in a match of the number twos, and that is a 5-0 head-to-head record in favor of RBA, 3-0 on hard courts. But the last time they played on a hard court, it went five sets at the Australian Open in 2019. So Milman does know how to put up a fight against RBA. Let's go now over to Group C, where we have Dominic Thiem's Austria against Matteo Berrettini's Italy. And Thiem versus Berrettini, that is a very close matchup. It's 2-2 in their head-to-head. It's actually 2-1 in favor of Berrettini on a hard court. And Berrettini won their last match, which was back in 2019 at the ATP Finals. So Dominic Thiem, his first match of the season, it might be a bit of a struggle and it could be an upset. Then we have the number twos going at it with Dennis Novak versus Fabio Fognini. And the record at the moment is 1-0 in favor of Fognini, but they've never played on a hard court. And Fognini's coming back from injury, so maybe Dennis Novak can cause a little bit of an upset there. Going on to Group D now, and we have Russia versus Argentina. So Daniil Medvedev versus Diego Schwartzman, 5-0 head-to-head record in favor of Medvedev, 4-0 on hard court. And last year, Medvedev was 3-0 against Schwartzman on hard court, only in 2020. So Schwartzman's going to have to do something insane to get the win over Medvedev, I think. Then we have Rublev versus Pella. 1-0 in favor of Rublev is their head-to-head, 1-0 on a hard court. And Rublev's stats last year on hard courts was 31 wins, 8 losses, and 4 titles. So Pella's going to have to put up a hell of a fight if he's going to beat one of the best hard court players of 2020. Moving back up to Group A now, and we have Germany versus Canada. We've got Zverev versus Shapovalov in the first matchup, and it's actually 3-2 in favor of Zverev, but on a hard court, it's 2 matches each, 2 wins apiece. And Shapo has won their last two, so that is going to be very interesting to see how Zverev plays against someone like Shapovalov, who loves playing for his country. And there could be a little bit of an upset there with Shapo getting the win over Zverev because he's on a bit of a roll in that head-to-head. Then you have Struff versus Raonic. Raonic has their head-to-head record at 2-1, but it's 1-1 on a hard court, but we all know Raonic had a great second half of the season last year and was 22 wins, 8 losses on hard courts in 2020, whereas Struff was 14 wins, 12 losses, and Raonic did really well in Cincinnati and Paris at the end of last year, so he's on a bit of a roll as well. Moving back to Group B now, and we have Greece versus Australia. Battle of the number one, Tsitsipas versus Dimonor. Tsitsipas has a 3-0 winning record over Dimonor. 3-0 all on hard courts, by the way. But Dimonor did win a tournament at the very start of 2021. He's on a bit of a roll. He won a tournament in Turkey. So he's on a little bit of a roll at the moment with some confidence. So who knows? He might be able to cause an upset for the very first win against Tsitsipas. Then we have Pervolarakis versus Milman in the match of the number twos. And these two have actually played the ones before, with Milman having the win on a hard court. And that was actually the ATP Cup last year. It was a 3-setter. It was very close and very entertaining. So that should be a fun one to watch for you hardcore fans. Back to Group C, and we have Italy versus France. Now, this is one of the closest matchups, in my opinion. We have Berrettini versus Monfils. 1-0 in favor of Berrettini, and their only match they played was actually a 5-setter epic match at the US Open back in 2019. Quarterfinals, you guys might remember. That was an epic match. So these two have played only that one time, but it was memorable. So that will be a lot of fun. Then we have Fanini versus Pear in the second match. Battle of the racket smashers. And the record is actually 3-1 in favor of Pear, but it's 1-1 on a hard court. And both of those hard court matches went the distance. 1-3-setter, 1-5-setter. And like I said, these guys like to throw a racket or two, and they like to argue, so this should be a lot of fun. Let's go back up to the last match in Group A, and that is Djokovic's Serbia versus Zverev's Germany. Battle of the top 10s. I'm interested to see how it goes. 4-2 is the head-to-head record for Djokovic over Zverev. 3-1 on hard courts, and Djokovic has won their last three matches. So Zverev actually had a good record over Djokovic, but Djokovic has turned the tables in the last couple of matches. Then we have Lajovic versus Struff, with Struff having a 1-0 head-to-head record win, with Struff actually getting the one win on a hard court, but that was back in 2014, so they haven't played for a long, long time. But Lajovic doesn't play very well against guys who are 6'4" and above, and Struff has a big serve at 6'6". So maybe Lajovic might find himself in some trouble. Back into Group B now with the last match of this group. Nadal versus Tsitsipas, another top 10 battle. And funny enough, Nadal actually has a massive winning record, 6-1 over Tsitsipas. And that's 4-0 on hard courts. So those wins aren't all just clay events, a lot of hard court events as well. But their last two matches have been 3-setters. And the last time they played was at the ATP Cup in 2020. So they have played recently, and Tsitsipas put up a bit of a fight. So we'll see if Tsitsipas can get his first win over Rafa on a hard court. Then you have RBA versus Pervolarakis. They've never played before, so this is going to be interesting to see how RBA can adjust. But RBA in the 2020 ATP Cup went through that whole tournament without losing a set, and he won six matches, and the only other player to win six matches at the ATP Cup last year, Novak Djokovic. So he is in good form at this event. He loves playing for his country, and he loves playing the ATP Cup. Going on to Group C now, we have Austria versus France. Team versus Monfils. Now, this matchup is very one-sided. 6-0 in favor of Team, 3-0 on hard courts, and Team has won 6 of 7 sets on a hard court. So Monfils has only won the one set against Dominic Team on a hard court. Then we have Novak versus Pear. That matchup is a little bit closer, with 1-1, both of those matches being on a hard court. And the last time they played was actually in 2020, and Novak won that match in straight sets. So this is probably Austria's best chance to get a good win here in both their singles matches. Then the final match of the groups, we have Schwartzman versus Nishikori. Nishikori actually has a 3-1 record against Schwartzman, 1-0 on hard court. And Schwartzman was 10 wins, 11 losses on hard courts in 2020. So we know Schwartzman had a great 2020, but all those great results were actually on clay courts. Not a great hard court player, so maybe Nishikori, even though he's coming back from injury, might be able to put some pressure on Schwartzman's hardcore game. Then we have Pella versus Nishioka, and it's 1-0 in favor of Pella, but they've never played on a hard court. Both players have played well at this event in the past. Moving over to my predictions for this tournament, I have picked an underdog pick and a winning pick. My underdog pick is Team Canada. I think they have the best 1-2 punch going around. I know Spain have RBA, they've got Nadal, but Raonic is probably the best number two player outside of Rublev. And even against Rublev, if they play, I put my money on Raonic to beat Rublev. I think Canada are going to do some upsets. I think they're going to surprise. So Canada are my underdog pick, but my pick for the tournament is Spain. I think Rafa Nadal, RBA, they played amazing last year and they only got stopped by the number one in the world, Serbia. I don't think Serbia are going to get out of their group. Like I said, I think Canada's going to win their group against both Serbia and Germany, which means that Rafa Nadal doesn't have anyone to worry about. He doesn't have to worry about playing Novak Djokovic, who he has a terrible record on hard court against. So I'm excited to see that. I think Rafa's going to win the ATP Cup. He loves playing for his country. He's got a solid doubles team behind him, and RBA hasn't lost a set in the singles at the ATP Cup. So there are my picks. Let me know down in the comments below, what are your picks? Who is your underdog pick, and who is your likely winning pick? I pick Spain to win it all, but I'm not surprised if Canada do something crazy, because they do love playing for their countries. You know, you do see Chapeau getting so pumped up when he's playing Davis Cup and even ATP Cup last year. So there you have it, the ATP Cup preview, and there are some blockbuster matchups in this tournament.